لا إله إلا الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا اللهم على من عادانا. اللهم ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا. اللهم ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا يا رب العالمين. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him, and he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I do bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds and give us blessings inshallah in this blessed days. Respected brothers in Islam, in today's khutbah inshallah, very short khutbah, I will do my best to highlight a very simple, quick concept, which is islah dhat al-bayn, to fix and to repair the relations, the broken relations between the people, on top of them husbands and wife. Actually, I'm trying to fix a concept as well through this hadith. The hadith is narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi. It's a sound hadith where Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Ala ukhbirukum bi afdali min as-salati was-siyami was-sadaqa." Look how Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is using this educational way sometimes. He surprises them. It's as if my language now, my words, as if Prophet Muhammad is aware, which is the case. He is aware that Muslims, they know, which is the case, that when you do the nafil prayer, for example, it's you will have a lot of ajr, okay? Night prayer, qiyam, mashallah, it's great. In the same time, sadaqah, great. Tens of hadith about this. When you do siyam, salah, sadaqah, as nafil, it's one of the greatest. Who can always be able to do these things? Yet, Prophet Muhammad came to fix a possible misconception. He came to give like a golden rule or an added value to something that many people might not be aware, which is, قال ألا أخبركم. Don't you want to tell me? Said, definitely, يا رسول الله. بلا يا رسول الله. Definitely, please, let us know what. قال إصلاح ذات البين. You know, ذات البين, it means to fix, to repair, to mend broken ties, broken relation between two people, which is applicable on two brothers, two friends, two colleagues, husband and wife, father and son, mother and son, mother and son, mother and daughter, father and daughter, whatever. All possible. As long as there is two people and there's a problem between them, when you interfere with the intention of fixing the problem, with the intention of repairing this, okay? Adding something just to, as we say, to try to pull the fuse. You know, sometimes you just pull it. When you pull it, everything will calm down. Bring good news for each other. Try to cleanse the hearts with the intention of fixing this problem. It's one of the greatest deeds in Islam, according to the Sahih Hadith. Many people might not be aware. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, in Surah Al-Anfal, imagine, you know, Surah Al-Anfal, it came in the occasion of that there was some kind of dispute between some Muslims after finishing one of the battles. So when they seized this kind of, you know, al-ghanaim, you know, this kind of what they have captured from the enemy after, they have some kind of dispute. So their hearts, they were about to have some kind of bad attitude. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them, he was talking,
يسألونك عن الأنفال، الأنفال لله والرسول، قال فاتقوا الله وأصلحوا ذات بينكم. Forget now your gainings. Forget the money that you will have. Forget what kind of, you know, health that you might be. Forget. أصلحوا ذات بينكم. Settle down the affairs between you. Don't let this spread. Now let's continue the hadith of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He continues in the hadith. He says, قال فإن فساد ذات البين هي الحالقة. لا أقول تحلق الشعر ولكن تحلق الدين. It's a metaphor. Then he continues, he said, if we do not do islah that al-bayn, fixing, repairing, the opposite is fasad that al-bayn. You know, when you have this corruption in the relations. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made benefit of a metaphorical usage. He said, فَإِنَّهَا الْحَالِقَ, it will be shaving. قال, it will not be shaving your hair, it will be shaving your religion. It's a metaphor. When we shave, what we do? We take off completely the hair. This is shaving. So as if the religion, the ethics, the manners, the values, like the hair. فساد ذات البين, the corruption, the relation between the people, as if someone is bringing a razor and just, you know, cutting off the deen itself. No good relation, which means full corruption. It is amazing. To a degree, one of the evidences about this, which I always mention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he mentioned the magic, you know, magic is from the major sins in Islam. Dealing with magic, approaching magicians, accepting them, believing in them is kufr in Islam. It's a major sin. It's equal to shirk, to zina, and qatil. It's the major sins, kaba'ir. When Allah mentioned magic in the Quran, at the very time it was mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, it's mentioned in the context of magicians, the only example that Allah mentioned on what magicians they do in terms of harm and destruction, it was just يُفَرِّقُونَ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَزَوْجِهِ. That they use their magic to split, to destroy, to separate the husband and the wife. It's one of the examples from Ifsad that al-Bayn. But it is the most dangerous. Because when you do Ifsad, when you corrupt relation between husband and wife, you have destroyed the nuclear brick of the society, which is the family. It's one of the aspects. But however, Ifsad that al-Bayn always is bad, always is corruption. But the most, the worst of it is between husband and wife. That's why when magic is mentioned, Allah mentioned, يُفَرِّقُونَ بِهِ بَيْنَ مَرْءٍ وَزَوْجِهِ. On the contrary, Prophet Muhammad is paying our attention. Look, as if Prophet Muhammad is saying, it's my words now, as if saying, look, it's good to do the prayer, right? It's good, but be careful. If you know that there is something, I'm showing you. Go and fix the relation. Go and repair between the people. Go and bring them together. Go and repair, fix the broken hearts, okay? Because when a problem happens between two people, everyone will feel that he is or she is the victim. And emotionally, most of the cases, every one of them will feel that I will not start anything. He did such and such. She did such and such. They can't. They need a third party. Always. This is by nature. We always need the third party. Instead of letting this party be the lawyer or the police officer or the judge or the court, let it be one of us to gain the ajr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد, يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. Now to fix this relation, to make it very clear in our minds, I will be quoting something I've already highlighted tens of times in my life and even here in this masjid, in this place. The two hadiths that Imam Bukhari narrated in his book Al-Adab Al-Mufrad about the two women from the time of the Sahaba. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting, a number of Sahaba they were sitting with him. ذكرت فلانة عند رسول الله قالوا يا رسول الله فلانة تصوم شهرها وتقوم الليلة وتتصدق بالمال الكثير لكنها تؤذي جيرانها بلسانها. قال لا خير فيها, هي من أهل النار. قال وذكرت فلانة عند رسول الله قال يا رسول الله فلانة لا تصوم إلا شهرها ولا تصل ولا تقوم الليل وتتصدق بالمال القليل بالأثوار. قال ولا تؤذي أحدا بلسانها. قال هي من أهل الجنة. It's like repairing the concept of refixing the concept. Now, two women from Sahabiyya, they were mentioned in the existence of Prophet Muhammad, the presence of him. One of them used to be well known as someone who's fasting most of the year, praying the Qiyam most of the year, paying a lot of sadaqah most of the time. But however, she used to harm the people with her tongue. Backbiting, you know, gossip, rumors, spreading lies, whatever, you know. The tongue is much more sharper than a sword, as we say. جُرْحُ اللِّسَانِ, in Arabic they say, أَنْكَ مِنْ جُرْحِ السِّنَانِ, which means the sharpness of the tongue is much more worse than the sword. Then another woman, the Prophet Muhammad, he declared his judgment against her. He said, لا خير فيها, there is no good in what she's doing. But she's she's destroying the society. قال هي من أهل النار. She is from the people of the hellfire. Then another woman was mentioned. Ya Rasulullah, another woman, she does not pray but Ramadan. There is no nafil, no extra. No ithnina khamis, you know, Mondays and Thursdays, nothing at all. Ayyam al-Bid, you know, nothing, just Ramadan and that's it. Okay, and she prays just the fard. There is no qiyam, no extra, no duha, no nothing at all. And she's poor. She does not donate but something very little. قال ولا تؤذي أحدا بلسانها. She's always keeping her mouth silent. She does not bring rumors, lies. She does not spread. Whatever comes to her, it stops by her. خلاص, it's finished. She's not enjoying this. قال هي من أهل الجنة. She is from the people of the Jannah. This should help us, and I'm on top of you, I'm the beginning, so help us how to reevaluate our deeds in our life. It's not just to keep just praying. It's good, ra'a, but be careful. You have to be careful. You have some other things will bring us ajr, and some other things might make us losing the ajr without paying attention. On top of them, if islah, وإفساد ذات البين, you know, to bring people together, or والعياذ بالله, God forbid, to destroy relation between the people by our tongues or by our deeds. Finally, before we finish, إصلاح ذات البين, fixing or repairing, bringing down, fixing the broken hearts, feeling between the people, could take just few minutes from you, by the way. A message, telephone call. Just to make, you know, to soften their hearts on each other. Yes, wallahi, he missed you. Wallahi, she missed you. Wallahi, whenever we talk about you, she start to cry. Really? Wallahi, she missed me? Yes. But I thought she hates me. No, wallahi, she does not hate you. Maybe just one telephone call. Maybe you will help both of them to think how to come back again. Because they have 5 kids. They will be thrown in the street for a very silly thing. And it could be really, in 70 to 80% of the cases, very silly things. Wallahi, something has no weight at all. But subhanAllah, shaitan comes and put his icing sugar. But we made the cake. It's our cake. However, the shaitan is very clever in the icing sugar and some chocolate decoration. he gives the added value. But it's us who, you know, prepare the cake. And for the day, you said, etc. So let's try to look again how to deal with these things, inshallah, in our life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of us, inshallah, to be from the best Muslims, understanding what should be done in the best manner for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وتعالى أن يجعلنا ممن يصلح ذات البين في حياتنا. اللهم آمين. اللهم ارحمنا واغفر لنا وعافنا واعف عنا. اللهم تجاوز عنا تقصيرنا يا رب العالمين. سبحانك ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة.